Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. We have just been so busy with another business project that we had that we haven't been able to even look at our garden, and today it was just screaming at us, look at us, we're beautiful. So we came out, and sure enough, the daffodils are gone. These have to be trimmed down now because I don't want all of the energy going into the seed pods. I want them to go back into the bulbs. So those will be trimmed. But look at this. This is one of the tulips that I planted last fall. And we had no idea what they would look like, of course, except from the package. And the package couldn't have told us how beautiful that would be. But if you look right next to it,
we had a visitor.
This has all been nibbled off, including the top.
Wow.
Now that could have been from before I sprayed, because I did have to spray. They were after our other tulips, so maybe I saved that one by spraying. These were from last year. They came up again. They're beautiful. Got a lot of weeding going here. And then there are these who came up last year too, but they weren't this large because they were only 1 year old last year.
Well, not only that, but they had just blossomed. We came out the next day and every head was gone. We had little deer friends who came to visit
so
and
we
munch.
We were careful to spray them. They did nibble some. I really didn't think we'd even have this many before I sprayed them because they nibbled them down almost to the ground. But
now, what did you spray them with?
I sprayed them with liquid fence, which I've talked about before. It's a combination of rotten eggs and other horrible smelling things. And when you put it on, it's awful. But when it dries, we can't smell it anymore. But the deer can and the rabbits can. So it definitely has helped. But I just can't get over the shape of these. They're just gorgeous.
They are.
And the color.
They really are.
If you painted something like that, it would look fake.
Yeah. Well, let's take a quick little tour around and just see all the things that are popping up. Let's start with that blossoming tree.
Now, this is the tree that I used to have outside my kitchen window, but it just got too large and we moved it over here. This is a flowering cherry. It doesn't produce fruits that we can eat, but it certainly is beautiful in the spring. And I think it loves it right here. It used to be in the shade. Now it's in full sun.
Yep. Okay, let's see what else.
Okay. Well, we see the peonies are coming up. Those will be shortly.
We got several batches of them along the road here.
Yep. This is our Japanese peony that we bought several years ago. And it's very happy. And this year is perfect for it. It was cold enough, long enough. And now it's beautiful.
Well, plus when they open, they have this beautiful kind of yellow interior as well.
Yes, and all of these little seedlings coming up are asters that have seeded themselves from last year. And here we have dwarf irises, and all of this beautiful creation here is lungwort. I don't know what that is. I'm sorry. I want to say scabiosa, but I'm not sure.
I call it Lynn's hair. Look at that. It looks just like you.
Thank you. And then we have the fringed tulips. These are the first year for these. I was afraid maybe the deer would get them, but I sprayed these too. Now, believe it or not, this is a tulip. Let me turn it a little bit.
Isn't that amazing?
Just gorgeous.
And then what else is coming up down there?
Right, and then here's another one. This was the pink one, and then there were also the purple ones that are just coming out. And behind them is a white bleeding heart.
That's a big one, too.
And behind them is a yellow tulip, and then also a meadow lily. But when we came out today and saw these, I mean, it was just, there were so many colors. They say keep a palette of colors that are in the same range. how can you when you've got orange and pink and yellow and white,
blue and purple?
I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous.
It blew us away when we came out this morning because, you know, like I said, we've been so busy, and unfortunately we haven't been able to be in our garden for about the last week. And so to come out here and see this was just a visual palette of, you know, it's hard to explain if you're not a gardener. If you are a gardener, well, you already understand what's going on. Amazing. Just amazing.
No, I missaid. This is a woodland poppy, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Another bleeding heart in the back
bleeding
there. More
hearts,
lungwort.
Right. This is a ground cover that has purple flowers. Maybe you saw it over there. Again, more of the tulips I planted last year. These look like they're going to be white.
That's amazing. Look how big this bleeding heart is already.
It's now mixed in with our whirligig
here. That's got to be close to almost 3 foot tall already.
Yes. Yep.
Hop in there once, just for a. Yeah, that's amazing.
These are what our grandson calls beating hearts. He couldn't say bleeding hearts last year. He would say beating hearts.
We got more tulips coming up over here.
Yes.
And then let's go over to the mound.
Rose bush is attacking me. Well, I scattered tulips everywhere. So here are some more. They're like double and triple full. Here's some more beautiful white ones.
Isn't that incredible? Wow.
Now it looks like a bride's bouquet to me,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Really?
I mean
those are absolutely gorgeous. Lovely. We didn't even get to the mound yet.
No, we didn't. We got sidetracked. Some more purple.
Just look at this. Just all over the place. Such a pleasant surprise.
And there I put a lot of different colors together. I was after a grouping.
You got a grouping, all right. And then we're over here. Just all the way down.
Everywhere you look, there's a color. Something is blossoming. And after one thing gets done, something takes over. These are anemones. And here's one of our $12.99 grocery store red Japanese maples from last year.
And look what's about to pop open soon as well.
Here's some more. Yep.
Yeah, and it's about ready.
Now this is allium, right? This will be a purple ball when it gets ready.
Okay, and then your bush that's starting to flower?
Right, I'm not quite sure what that is. But it sure is pretty.
Yeah. More tulips.
Smells good too.
Your forsythia is still going strong.
Smells wonderful.
Now the reason we wanted to get out here today rather than wait till tomorrow was because?
It's supposed to rain, and we hope it rains. We need some rain. So we wanted to get them before the rain came. And the other day we had this wind storm that came out of nowhere. Luckily, we didn't have any damage, but
65 mile an hour.
That was
something. Came whipping through.
Yep. And now that I'm looking over your shoulder, we need to look at those purple flowers behind you.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we bought these 2 years ago, I believe, and last year they were tiny. This year they're huge. They start out with a pink blossom, and it turns blue as it matures. And once they're done blooming, they die down completely to the ground. And if you don't remember that they're there, you won't remember until next spring when they pop back up again.
And then all of your honeysuckle that we've just planted, we showed those in another video.
Yes, but if you also look behind that, all those bright green, this is the lily of the valley, which I dearly love, but this is what we tried to eradicate last year by digging it out.
They're back.
I've already hit them once with the spray. They're gonna get sprayed again.
Wow.
Yes, they've come back with a vengeance.
Well, Mother Nature has its way of getting even, doesn't it? Wow, well, that is quite an incredible flurry of flowers today.
One more.
Oh, one more?
I need to show you in the back.
Where are we going?
Before we go to the back, I wanted to stop at the strawberries and show you that they are blossoming already. The deer haven't been too bad on these, but you never know once we get some. But you can see there they are.
Well, look over there. That's just all full of blossoms.
Yes.
And we put in 200 new plants last year. I think we had 6 different varieties, if I recall. Some mm-hmm. were everbearing, some were June bearing.
Right, some were mid-season.
So, yeah, so it'll be interesting to get a batch.
And this has to be our most exciting discovery of all. Thank you, Steve Lau. You know who you are. You kept faith that these little peony trees would come, and lo and behold, here they come. Now, we planted these a year ago. This whole bed has them in here, and there's a bunch of weeds in here too, but they did nothing all last summer. Then it got really hot, and he told us they won't germinate if it's over 80. And he was right. He said, put them in the ground and just leave them. And after winter, after they've been cool, they will germinate. And here they come.
Well, how many varieties did I get you? 32 different varieties and colors of peony trees. You'll have to go back to see one of our videos on peony trees.
Yes.
It's amazing. I mean, black ones and red ones and purple,
blue ones,
green,
and
yellow,
green ones.
Lime.
Yep.
I mean, you name the color. I think we have the seeds now for them. Plus, we only planted, how many seeds did I get? 4,000?
Either 4 or 2. I don't remember anymore.
Yeah, maybe it was 2,000, but we only planted half of them.
Right. Just in case.
Yeah, we didn't know.
So here they are.
How exciting is that?
Very exciting.
Boy, I'm glad we spent time in the garden today. I feel guilty.
Yes, I know. But now we can give them some water and they can continue their growing.
I'll go turn the water on.
And these were the tulips that we were so impressed with last year that they just kept going on and on and on. When they first open up, they're mostly white. And then as they mature, they get more and more pink. I mean, that almost looks like a rose.
It really does. I mean, for a tulip, what a wonderful creation. You know, I often wondered what exactly is it that professional gardeners do to actually create new species like that. It's really
it's an art and a science.
Yes.
At the same time.
I'm sure it's a trade secret.
I'm sure it is. And then you can see in the back a plethora of different colors.
Yep, I see the ferns are coming up. Apple trees that we just put in look really good. Look at that color. And that is just nibbable.
No, that's what I spray them for,
Richard. Oh, okay. Well,
no nibbling.
I can understand the deer's passion. What a delight to look at, isn't it?
Yes.
Gardeners are so lucky. Even that, you still have daffodils going mm-hmm. way back in there.
Yes, they will. See, they're in the shade, so they came later than the other ones.
Yeah. And some back over there where the ferns are coming up.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would say that you have planted a lot of beautiful bulbs, and now, fortunately, today we had the pleasure of living with them.
Yes.
Amongst them.
Yes. I mean, I don't even need to pick them to bring them in. They're just gorgeous where they are.
Yeah.
So thank you, God, for supplying them all for us and our pleasure. So if you enjoyed this little walkthrough, give us a thumbs up. If you'd like to subscribe, we'd love to have you, and I'd love to hear from you. I'm going to get back now and start answering all my comments Thank you for sending them. Well, I've just been too busy.
I've got to the computer today, and I can tell you that you're probably going to have about 60 or more comments waiting for you. It's just amazing. I mean, they are literally pouring in.
Thanks, guys and girls.
And also, if you're ever in the neighborhood, please stop in. In fact, if you're ever visiting Wisconsin, we're just west of downtown Milwaukee, maybe about, I'd say, a 45-minute drive at most. And, mm-hmm. You know, we're a little garden, but boy, we sure have a lot of goodies here.
We're packed.
Yep. And also, if you're a first-time viewer, please go to wisconsingarden.com and enjoy over, well, now you've got over 400
yes,
videos up and running already, and they're all free. So enjoy them, and again, we'd love to hear from you.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
Oh, I still think I want to nibble on some of these.